friends, the next important topic that we are going to discuss under medical first aid is hypothermia. Now, hypothermia is a medical condition or a medical emergency that occurs when your body loses heat faster than the heat it can produce. So that is when hypothermia takes place. Now, the normal core body temperature is the important question which is asked by the survey. What is the normal body temperature? It is 37 degrees centigrade, or it's around 98.6 Fahrenheit. And hypothermia occurs as your body temperature falls below 35 degrees centigrade or 95 Fahrenheit. So that is when hypothermia occurs. Then what are the types of hypothermia? That is mild hypothermia, moderate hypothermia, and severe hypothermia. Now, mild hypothermia takes place when the cold body temperature falls below 35 degrees centigrade to 32 degrees centigrade. And moderate hypothermia occurs when the core body temperature falls below 32 degrees centigrade to 28 degrees centigrade. And severe hypothermia occurs when the core body temperature falls below 28 degrees centigrade. So this is when these types of hypothermia occur. Now, in mild hypothermia, the person is conscious but is shivering, and has some numbness. In moderate, the person is semi-conscious. He's not shivering. Slightly, the body turns a bit of blue, and he's semi-conscious in this state. In severe hypothermia, the person is unconscious and the whole body turns blue. Now, coming to the causes of hypothermia. Now, the causes at sea is immersion into sea. Now, immersion into sea, that too in cold water conditions. Okay, in temperate zones, this won't happen. In your tropical zones, this won't happen. This is only in your high latitudes where the temperature of the water is 0 degrees or it is cold enough. Now, all the presence of cold air. These are the two places where your hypothermia may occur. And how is the diagnosis to be done in three stages? There are excitation stage, aerodynamic stage, and stage of torpor, which apparently leads to death. Now, in excitation stage, what happens is marked shivering takes place, confusion, disorientation of the person's behavior. Then aerodynamic stage is when amnesia takes place, heart slows, and possible abnormal rhythms. The heart rhythms are abnormal. And amnesia is loss of partial or complete loss of memory is what amnesia is. Then there is a stage of torpor in which muscle rigidity, pupils dilate, then muscles relax and apparently leads to death. So these are the diagnosis stages. Then treatment as it is core body heat loss. So we have to do rewarming in order to do the treatment. So rewarming is by giving blankets, heat pads, heat packs, warm water immersion, and this has to be done in a moderate way. Okay, never do the warming in an extreme condition. Do it in a very moderate condition. Then warmed IV fluids, warm humidified oxygen is also given. Then warm soups and no alcohol to be given. Now, warm soups, this can be given to person who is conscious. Okay, never give oral fluids to person who is unconscious. When a person is unconscious, surely you can give him IV fluids, warmed IV fluids. And so this is how you are going to do the treatment. And never give alcohol to a person for treating hypothermia. Then instruments required to check hypothermia or the core body temperature is your rectal thermometer. This is an important instrument. And kindly have a look at the pics ahead for better understanding. Question is the types of injections which are given. First is intramuscular, subcutaneous, intravenous, and intradermal. These are the four types of injections which we give. Now, intramuscular is given at a 90 degree, and subcutaneous is given at 45 degree. Intravenous is given at 25 degree, and intradermal is given at 10 degree to 15 degree. As you can see, this is the structure of our skin. Just for understanding purpose, I have drawn it like this. Now, the first layer is epidermis, second is the dermis, third is the subcutaneous tissue, and then is your muscles. Now, you give intramuscular, the name suggests, intramuscular is the name. As the name suggests, this injection has to be given to the muscles. So, this is given at 90 degree, as you can see in the figure over here. Then comes your subcutaneous, which is given at 45 degrees. This is to be given at your subcutaneous tissue. So this is given at 45 degrees. Intravenous, it is given directly to the veins. So this is given at 25 degrees. Now intravenous is when you give a intravenous or IV, it directly goes into the bloodstream and hence has a very quick effect compared to rest of the injections. Then comes your intradermal, which is given at 10 to 15 degrees. Intradermal examples are your usually vaccines, what we give is intradermal. So this is about the types of injections. Under medical first aid, few important questions which are asked by surgeons regularly is what is medical chest? Now, medical chest is a locker in which medicines are kept on board. So that is your medical chest. Then what is medical scale? Now, medical scale is a list of medicines which are required to be carried on board. Now, this is as per your ship, the area of trade and the cargo which is carried on board. So based on these two criteria, your medical scale is made. Now your medical scale, you'll find your medical scale under the MFAG, which is Medical First Aid Guide. Your MFAG is a part of your IMDG supplement. IMDG has three volumes, volume 1, volume 2 and the supplement. Medical First Aid Guide comes under the supplement, and under Medical First Aid Guide you'll find the medical scale. That's where you'll get your medical scale. Now the next question is, how to use Ship Captain's Medical Guide? Where is it present on board? Now Ship Captain's Medical Guide, this is present in the ship's medical cabinet. And how do you use it now, and what are how do you use it? So your medical ship captain's medical guide, it enables you to diagnose the injured and sick seafarers. How do you use it? Go to the index which is present at the end of the booklet, see the required problem, go to the specified page, and then after going to the specified page, look for your general and specific treatment which you want to perform to the to related that problem. So that's how you use your ship captain's medical guide. Then comes the next question is, what is IMGS? It is International Medical Guide for Ships. This is published by WHO and IMO together. Then next question, what is Medical First Aid Guide, MFAG? As I told you, MFAG comes under supplement to IMDG, and it is a Medical First Aid Guide. Then how will you intake medicines on board? This is very important questions regularly asked by surveyors. So how will you intake medicines on board? Your intake medicines on board taking into account the IMGS requirements, your flag state requirements, and your medical scale requirements. These three important points you have to speak up in order to give the correct answer. So International Medical Guide for Seafarers for ships has recommended medicines to be carried on board for ship types, then along with the circular issued by flag state. So flag state requirement also has to be fulfilled along with the IMGS. Then your medical scale for special vessels as per supplement to IMDG. Your medical scale is as per the area of trade and the cargo carried on board. So all the three criteria have to be fulfilled before indenting the medicines on board. So these are a few important questions which are asked by surveyors and their answers.